Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the D2CL. I'm your host for the English live stream, going through our both European and US games tonight. We have a double Na'Vi head up, as we have Na'Vi EU going up against Fnatic right now. After Na'Vi EU getting beaten in game number one, they definitely fought to the last man, but the last man wasn't enough. Fnatic triumphed their way through in their first game of the D2CL, and we'll see if they can do it again, as Hani is going to try and draft their way to victory up against FNG right now. Of course, it is as I said, not the only game of the night coming up for the D2CL. We have Na'Vi US going up against Sneaky Nick's Assassins. That game will be coming up shortly after this one, so definitely stay tuned for the action there. We'll be having a lot more games coming your way tonight. And of course, tomorrow the games will continue as well. We have Na'Vi US versus CNB, as well as Union Gaming versus Not Today. Those games will be happening then on the 12th. And then we have a couple of breaks. And then Cloud9 VP, Empire versus PR, Na'Vi versus Tinker, Cloud Rangers versus Cloud9 versus Power Rangers will also be happening. And that's all going to be coming up next week. So keep your eyes peeled for that one. And of course, everything else that joinDOTA is doing over at joinDOTA.com. The draft is already underway. So Na'Vi will burn out. They just profited this game. So again, no split push being allowed from the lineups here. The Wisp will, however, be allowed through the draft, and Hani prioritizing the Doombringer over absolutely everything else. And this has kind of stopped FNG in his tracks of this draft, making him burn through almost all of his normal time. They banned out the Razor. Obviously, I want to deal with Trixie on that again. And then the Krob and the Lycan, and obvious bans coming out from Fnatic. Fnatic will just get, well, the Batrider for now. And then they'll consider their other lane options. And again, looks like we're going to go for some of the same. The only thing that was just making this game a little bit different right now is the fact that one Razor's being banned out. And two, Fnatic had first pick. Where in the last game it was Na'Vi who had first pick. But Na'Vi decided to stay on Dire side. But they'll have the Batrider again, as well as the Mirana. They could mix it up a little bit with the Mirana. She could be a support in this game, but judging from games past, we'll be looking at again another Mirana core from Hvorst. It's just if they could think that's enough to deal with the Doombringer. If they don't think that is enough, then they have to find another way to try and force the issue here.
Reserve time.
Liquid Fire would be one way of doing that with the Jakira. At the same time, Fnatic, like, you look at Harney's draft. You start off with the Doombringer. This guy can function almost anywhere. He can actually function anywhere. So all you then have
Fnatic's
to do is...
Oh,
seem really
ban.
Familiar? Yeah, it does. All you gotta do is just make sure your lanes are stable and you're good to go. The Batrider and the Mirana will force you a little bit, but your Doombringer showed you don't need a lot of farm, and then you can come in and be really, really successful. The Wraith King also worked nicely, and yeah, Na'Vi is going to be taking out the Ember Spirit to start with. Didn't really feel like the Ember was their problem in that game, though. The problem in that game was the Wraith King, I kind of want to flag as like a larger problem. The bigger problem was the Doombringer. The Doombringer just kept shutting down Dendi at the start of every single engagement. So there's no way they could get themselves up on top of it all. Sorry.
5 seconds remaining.
At Na'Vi and Fnatic. Fnatic going into their fourth bans now. So Tinko will be the ban out from Fnatic. They tried to take out this global control last time, but they're also going to remove this guy Wrathmage, so we won't have completely identical lineups again from Na'Vi at least. That's a lot of the heroes are being removed. Two of the previous ones from Fnatic's last game. But for that fourth ban now, what does he really feel like Fnatic could be doing? Fnatic, if they wanted to, and I kind of hope they do, they go down the lines of a hero like a Pugna. With a Mirana and a Batrider, Mirana kind of needs a little bit of time to find some items or needs a couple of good kills. Now, the great thing about the Pugna is he restricts your space. So even if you are capable of getting a couple of kills 10 minutes into the game, more than likely you've already lost out in one of your towers. So They actually take out the Earthshaker and just take the Wraith King themselves. Okay, so they block, Fnatic's pick Harney's last hero, and they also take out one of Harney's favorite heroes, which was the Earthshaker. I believe he actually ended up playing both of these heroes in their game versus Complexity earlier tonight. So FNG looks like they're just trying to shut down the secondary support. There's no way he can shut down the lanes. He has no idea what Fnatic will play. I think most of the annoying heroes of Na'Vi have already been removed. The Ember, the Razor, the Tinker, potentially Lycan, Prophet, and Krob. All these heroes are just your frustrating heroes. They could try and go for something more like a Viper. Would be an option. Considering Na'Vi's damage output right now isn't really that great, a Viper would be able to stand and fight throughout, well, most engagements. But that kind of, again, brings you back to a point where you have to understand your early laning phase needs to still go decently well. And you've got to be mindful about the rotating ganks coming out from Na'Vi. But if you take that into account, then great pickup. Give him a lot of mid-game potential. The Shadow Shaman pushing down towers with the wards. Viper behind him with a mech. And then Doombringer just running his little legs around, hoping to find someone he can catch out of position. All can work. So Fnatic have to make a decision for their third hero. Something tells me both Wraith King and Earthshaker were like their only two options they were searching at. And a Slark pickup.
Na'Vi's turn Disruptor. To pick.
And Na'Vi don't care. They go straight to Disruptor, which means that's either a core Wraith King or a support Mirana. What's great about the Disruptor is he's perfect up against the Slark. Glimpse him back and lock him in a wall with that Static Storm going down. Slark, of course, can... Like, Shadow Dance is still a very elusive ability, and Dark Pact, the timing for it's going to be right, but he could actually break free of Na'Vi control. But the teamfight control of Na'Vi is really quite good now, too. And the Doombringer, another hero. He's meant to chase and run away. But if you're able to have a glimpse on top of him, it's difficult then to say Doombringer will survive on the offlane. And a Venomancer pickup from Fnatic.
Turn to ban.
I kind of, like, missed their old roster where Trixie was the offlane Venomancer because I really enjoyed watching his Venomancer, especially when he knew how to man up. These days, we only get the Venomancers going as solo mids. And the primary culprit of that one is Sing Sing.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Alright, Brewmaster ban out from Na'Vi.
Fnatic's
maybe they're worried about
ban.
How many heroes they're going
to
control. The Brewmaster would have caused a little bit too much chaos. They don't have enough silence to go around when they've only got the Disruptor. And they don't really have a burst damage lineup, so Brewmaster, you'd need to keep him silenced, stunned, arrowed, lassoed. Almost everything you've got just to control him.
5 seconds.
In fact, right now, if Fnatic wanted to get really greedy, they could potentially pick up a Weaver.
Reserve time.
If he gets an early BKB, Disruptor will have no control over him. There would be the lassoes, but then if they use that on him, the Slark and Doombringer run free. But that kind of screws up all your lanes. Like, actually completely screws up your lanes. If it's a Venomancer in the middle lane, that puts a Shaman into a support role. The Enigma will then be a possibility for Fnatic. But it looks like Na'Vi is, with the Brewmaster ban, they flagged the fact that Venomancer, at least in FNG's mind, is a support hero.
Na'Vi's turn to pick.
Another teamfight controlling hero bend out. Taking out Dendi's Puck. And Na'Vi's got their choice now. So what is our Dendi hero for this game? Up against the Slark, up against the Doombringer. Two great melee heroes. They could try and go for the Viper. Venomancer would hate that.
10 seconds remaining.
Oh, I poison stinged him. Wait, corrosive. Arrgh.
5 seconds remaining.
Venomancer Ollie. Ah, corrosive.
Reserve time.
But FNG's taking some time for this, because if they do also go for that Viper pickup, like, you could just see Fnatic run circles around him, and the Viper ulti won't do as much up against a Doombringer and a Slark, because both are capable of either tanking or just running away. So, not as brilliant a hero. I say running away when you have Disruptor on the field, so maybe it is actually still a good hero. That's just what he wants to play in the mid lane. See, it's one of these games where I would have really liked to see him play a Pudge. The momentum you're able to get on it, the Doombringer might doom you up, but you're a Pudge! You're used to that kind of crap. And then you're able to have, like, up against a Venomancer, slow is not really a problem. If you hook him in, you're right, it's rain. Shadow Shaman, toast. Slark, you need the dismember to hold him in position, and then a whole bunch of teammates come in and help you out. I'm liking it for this game. There was actually an interview recently that came out too, saying, I think it was actually Havorse who said it. It's like, guys, like, Pudge is not a troll pick. Pudge is actually a legitimate hero that you can grab. But I don't know if FNG wants to go down that road for this game, at least. Especially when Fnatic still have one more hero to pick up, and they could completely change their lanes up. So they need to make sure the pick is at least going to work for them. But he's only got 7 seconds, so FNG, it's decision time, man. Remaining. Make your choice. Clockwork. And it's going to be a clockwork, which actually means we get a Dendi Batrider. Huh. So we get a Dendi Batrider. Unless he's playing the Miranda in the middle lane. That's another option you could be floating there. But that is most definitely a fun at Clockwork. The other option is Dendi that plays the Clockwork, but it's been... My brain can't recall a time when Dendi played Clockwork as a mid-solo. Because he always had the offlaners that would play it. Like back when Line of Heaven was playing for them. And if Funnet came in and replaced that role, he was always playing the Clockwork. The mid-solo clockworks are unknown. S4 played it a hell of a lot. With this kind of clockwork, I'm not that certain. And an undying pickup from Fnatic. Oh, bring on the aggro tri-lane. Leave Boogie on the safe. Put the Slark in the mid. And then run Undying Venomancer and Shadow Shaman up on the top lane. I got a feeling Fnatic's going to take 2-0. Just a feeling. Havorse will be the rating in this one. So it's actually a support Miranda. It will be a Dendi Batrider. It will be the Dendi Batrider. While the Venomancer will be the other core. Wait, what? It's an Undying support. Venomancer core. Yeah. And then Undying and Shadow Shaman combined with the Venomancer on the offlane. Leaves the Doombringer directly up against the Clockwork. Doombringer's going to want some armor against that as well. Some nice consumables. Or else Clockwork's going to completely zone him out. Just Cogburner, he can't use any of his abilities. So he needs a good aura.
5 seconds remaining.
It's Hani's Undying. So they'll have the support coming out from him. But everyone's inside the game. Don't know why we paused. Hani obviously did it. Maybe they just need a moment to get their thoughts about him. Already FNG. Like, he had time to buy up sentry wards. His tank goes and run directly north. So he's ready to move and fight already. And it'll be a Vent Score Miranda in this game. So that's the support we're talking about. And yeah, Funnix Clockwork. I really, really love his Clockwork set. There's just something about it. Because he's got like a... He combines up multiples. It's the face as well. Like the Havoc helmet, that just looks totally boss. But then the chest plate kind of looks like RoboCop. He doesn't have the head for it. Like it's actually autographed by, would you believe, Robo. I kind of wish he actually had the helmet. I think it's because he must like mustaches. All right, so we have one AFK. As I was saying, Navi's going to get a little testy about this because they have their first official game for the DreamHack Moscow in, well, roughly 7 to 8 hours or so. I kind of felt like this was later in the night, but it wasn't as late as I thought it was. Alright, so our aggro tri-lane, Trixie's actually coming up here as the Slark. With Undying and Venomancer. So it's actually a support Venomancer. Leaves Boogie on the bottom. And wait, no. No, really? Really? No. Trixie is built to farm. Passed as well as Hani. Like, a Boots first Venomancer could still be anything on the offlane, but Hani's most definitely a support. They're running a solo mid Shaman. It's kind of appropriate that Fnatic are like, maybe battle. They've done this in the past and I just missed the games, but it's rather appropriate that Fnatic are doing this again, considering when they first transitioned from Heroes of New Earth over to Dota 2, the mid-solo Shadow Shaman was one of the first things they were bringing into the play. And ended up becoming a full trend. But I'm interested to see how the Shaman goes. He's got Tankos and Null Talisman, which is why I was just like, yeah, he's there in the mid lane, so it should be right. Right, they should be good to go. Begins. Yeah, so Trixie will go top, and the Shaman will go mid. And Harding and Pass are waiting for a gank. They'll have to have a crack at a Vost. He'll be the Wraith King on this top lane. The support will be there from Vanskor and FNG, so the chance of this gank working on the top lane, I'm not so sure about it. Especially considering they've got no stuns, and if Pass misses his Gale, they're actually in a lot of trouble, because then there's no slow control over Na'Vi, who will have Arrow, Hellfire Blast, and Thunderstrike in the first levels. And Trixie's only got a pounce, so he's not really going to get a lot of momentum like from this. The arrow. Oh boy. The leash will be there for Avost. FNG. He's got Thunderstrike damage going in Trixie. The Gale will connect. Now Avost helped by a blast. They just try and turn dish out as much damage to Trixie as possible. They need more damage in one to finish him off. Vanskor can't reach him in time, and well, that actually ended up working. I don't know how that really. Well, actually, I do know how that worked. The arrow hit. And instead of Avost just running back up that direction, are they coming in again? Trixie can just pounce himself out. But instead of the supports just doubling back, they came in thinking, well, we hit the arrow, so we should be ahead right now. But it's not the case. Man, Batrider versus Shaman in the mid. How classic are we going tonight? Fnatic on this offlane should still be having himself some good times. 3-0 up against a 1-2 Doom. It got toughness aura, so as I said before, Boogie wanted to get an aura creep more than anything else. And Fnatic. Oh, he's gonna call Gam Battery Assault. I'm not so sure about this, Fnatic. You don't have the life points and you're tanking up the tower right now. Has to back up. Boogie, no Scorched Earth though. So he can't do anything with it. Meanwhile, up on top lane, FNG is battling from the cliff tops. While Harney just keeps decaying them up as often as he can. But you got Gale and Poison Sting out from Pass. So all the control in the world he searches for. It's like Clockwork's triggered off yourself. Boogie's holding on to his for the moment. Doesn't want to use it if he doesn't have to. So he uses Tangos for the moment. He gets to fight underneath his own tower. Which means again, Fnatic doesn't want to dive too far into this. So the Shaman's up to 10-2. Batrider 11-0 however, and Dendi managed to pick up an Invis rune as well. Coming out in the crew will be his boots. Needs to have that to battle up against the Shaman. Shaman's movement speed is pretty poor. He's got boots as well as a stick coming out, so he'll have a lot of charges up his sleeve. But that's basically all. He still won't win on the movement speed. 284 versus 3-3-4-0. Mystiki Napalm, 4 charges in it from Dendi. Like, he'll control this middle lane quite nicely. And now with an Invis rune, he's only using it for the ball charges. It's the only reason. Alright, so 1-0, 3 in. Fnatic still want to keep their momentum going on this top lane. Decaying in is just a little bit of chip now. Oh, almost got the leash. The leap away by Vanskor was at the right time. Just before the leash would be able to ensnare him. While Pass gets to battle directly on the lane. Got some really good harassment. The arrow's coming in. Trixie doesn't actually tank it for him. He almost said if he did, then Pass would survive through this. Avor's gonna get the KB. He drops the tombstone. Harney will try and stick around and fight up against this one. Avor's low on life. And there is your attack. And gets the kill from Undying. He's got Soul Rip available to keep Trixie alive. Decay in a moment. FNG's not gonna look too healthy with this. And Trixie's already considering coming in. Vanskor wafts the arrow. As now the leash does come in. It's over on FNG. Trixie copying a lot of damage with the Dark Pack. Lets him get the kill, shifting the essences out of Vanskor. So Vanskor leaps away. The attack in Harney will not be enough. But Wraith King will kill off Slark on the top lane. On the middle lane, what the hell happened to Dendi? He ends up dying to a Shadow Shaman while all that was going on. There it is. Shaman kills Dendi. In the middle of Undying killing off the Wraith King as well. So 4-2 now on the board. As Harney has to go all the way back to base. Decay charges war offense. He's so low on life now. While bottom lane, the Doombringer is rapidly approaching level 6. And Clockwork's gonna be careful about. Oh, Mass Open Wards! If you can get in range of the Shackles, the Glyphs are pulling back. But the Mass Open Wards are still in range of the tower. Saw how much damage FNG just took trying to defend that. But the wards will bring down this tower to half of its life points. They're trying to get rid of a couple of them, but FNG's base damage is pretty poor. So the tower's doing most of the work. But the tower will still drop to one third of its life points. And now it's a set of wards which potentially could have actually killed off Denny and then inflicted the damage to the tower. That early Shadow Shaman. 5 minute mass serpent wards. Now Denny's trying to get in range for, well, he can't get a last suit, he doesn't have the experience for it up yet. And the Shaman tries to battle for CS. Patrick's gonna get a lot of momentum shortly. He's up to level 5, the arrows are coming in again. The Centaur actually goes down, so Trixie does take the 5 second stun. But Vanskor can't do anything about this. He's got 4 points up, level 4. But he's got 2 points up in Leap, as well as 2 points up in the arrow. Which means there's no burst damage coming in from the Starfall. What level those Plague was? Level 1 pass. Wait till level 2 before you put them down. Plus you just start feeding over to the enemy. I think he just wandered because they have no vision on the side. Gale, oh, hit on Havorst. The Leash did manage to latch. The arrow will come in, but the minions from Harney will tank it up. The Force is already really slowed up. And with the minion army, they can just keep forcing this. The wall will hold him in position for now. Let's stay out of range of the tower. The Thunderstrike goes too. There is a level 2 glimpse, which is why they're not just backing up. And now he's managed to drag the creep wave back past their own tier 1 tower, so they're looking good. Thunder came in towards mid lane looking for a kill. It's a Shadow Shaman he wants, but Dendi's not available anymore. He's gone all the way back to base to heal up. This is a man with Tranquil Boots that gets forced out of the mid lane. The Shaman's doing a wonderful job. While the Doombringer is just hovering around. He's not 100% sure where the Clockwork is or a couple of the other supports of Na'Vi. So he's being cautious because of this. But now Denny will flag himself back in the middle lane. So there's no quick blink dagger. And looks like Shadow Shaman, they're going to take the tier 1 tower on the top. They don't need a smoke for this, but seems they're going to anyway. Just in case maybe there was a ward nearby. An FNG. Gale, the glimpse will send the Shaman back, but he's already done the damage with the extra shock pass. He did cop an arrow to the face from Vanskor, and the Soul Rip not actually fast enough from Harney to keep his Venomancer alive. But the Mass Serpent Wards, they get the trap on a Vorst. They're trying to find him out of there. Vanskor, he gets rid of one, but he's still trapped. The Shackles as well. Vanskor is trying to cut the path. The arrow hits on Harney. Now Dendi's also arrived with a Flame Break. A Hellfire Blast into Harney too, but they can't go too close this one. Clockwork will die at the Doombringer on the bottom lane. Sticky Napalm charges are there. Firefly off cooldown 1 second time. The arrow is searching. Well, from Vanskor, 1 second. Dendi up on top of the hill. And a way to safety. Still ticking out a little bit. That Plague Ward. Not giving him space. The arrow did connect on pass. The four heroes come up. We go 6 for 3. But the Doombringer just got a solo kill on the Clockwork. And that's what I was talking about when Doombringer hits level 6. Clockwork already has to be cautious as it is. Because once the Doom is on him, if he doesn't have battery assault, he's basically dead because the Scorcher just gets triggered and Doombringer chases him. But the fact that Doom's also picked up an Alpha Wolf creep, he's there to fight. He's also there to have 1400 gold. I'll have to go back to pick up all of his mana, but that means if he wants to become a brawler, well, probably will still go down the lines of treads. But the Miners is also another potential item. If they feel far enough ahead, Fnatic, which at the moment, it kind of feels like they're a lot further ahead than this. The aggro troll has been working a lot better, but Funnic, now he finally catches that pass. It's a level 1 Gale, so Funnic is only slowed. There's no damage, and now even powerful Plague Ward, just for good measure. But a good solo kill. That's what Clockwork needs to gain momentum. Dendi with the Invis rune. Shadow Shaman. Is he going to inch far enough forward? He should have seen it. The pings are coming out from Shaman saying, yo, Dendi is missing from mid. Funnic's here now. A Vorst will move in, and they just, okay, that's Firefly the creep wave. He might get himself up to this camp of Centaurs to farm it up too. There's a lot of pressure being added towards mid lane. One level up in Mass Open Wars, they just want to bring down a tier 1 tower. There's an injection of money which should have been here a long time ago for Fnatic, which has never arrived. And that's these early towers with the Shadow Shaman farming up. Now Trixie runs up. Smoke will end up breaking as we have a disconnection coming out from the Mirana. Waiting for Smart Astro Mark to come out from Fnatic. They already did it once earlier tonight. Wouldn't put it past them to do it again. But there's four heroes coming up, so they get completely spotted out coming in here. Now, if Na'Vi is also watching for this, they will notice too that Observe Ward just got planted. So it could be dewatered shortly after this. But they're staring down that tier 2 tower, that tier 1 tower in the mid. So Mirana's in, Trix is good to go whenever. And there's your resume. Came out from the disruptor. Fortification is available here for Na'Vi if they want to try and defend it. There's rocket spam, but there's no heroes in range. So I'll just let it go. There's no point fortifying this unless they're really going to mass TP in on it. And Fnatic had no hookshot available. There's no TP on FNG. He's too busy trying to get to those arcane boots right now. While Avorz is trying to farm up inside the jungle. Just watching this one Satyr attack a unit through the tree line. It's probably flagging some question marks here for Trixie. But FNG, there's our arcanes. Actually, no, he's got a... Did Fnatic really not give him the CS?
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Well, that's rather rude. Now he's got the arcanes. He's about to give the mana Dyer's over to Fnatic too. The pings are coming out, attack. But the mass serpent wards are on top of the tier 1 tower. And again, there's nothing that Na'Vi can Radiant's really do about this. The 5-man ball from Fnatic is too strong to fight against. Especially when Dyer's Doom is up. Top tower has it's only fallen. A level 2 Tombstone, but they're still going to cause it some problems. And the oldie from the Wraith King's on the sidelines, so Havoc doesn't have that reincarnation available. And without that, there's no real magic coming from this lineup. While Dendi triggers the TD rune. There's enough Plague Wars to keep this creep wave busy, not to mention the catapults also here. Now there's movement coming in from the Slark. The arrow, oh, Trixie, he actually leapt himself into it, but he leapt and Dark Pact at the same time, which allowed him to shrug off the stun at least. So Trixie just runs himself away and his Shadow Dance will regenerate him. In fact, now he's going to come down to bottom lane. Fnatic's already down here. He pings out the fact that Trixie did arrive. In fact, that was actually Denny that pinged out the fact that he disappeared. And they're bringing more support in, but at the same time, Boogie's also here. The leash won't latch on Fnatic. FNG, he might have to throw down this wall right now, but he can't do anything. The arrow's on the way in. He'll connect on Trixie while Fnatic tries to TP out to safety. He'll be successful, but Boogie, he wants this kill on FNG. FNG trying to juke him around the tree lines, but Undying uses the Decay to get the kill in. Small amount of damage, but it was enough. It's only a level 1, you'd never go anything more. 20 damage from the Undying Decay, and that's what it gets the kill with. Well. And now the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. Na'Vi can't give it up any- they can't give any more. Now, if Fnatic gets hookshot available, they'll have to TP for this. Wraith King ulti is up. First TP comes in from the Disruptors on the tier 2 tower. Now one on the tier 2, Fnatic with his hookshot. Trixie getting glimpsed back up again. Now with the ulti coming out from FNG, there's not an extra commitment for it. They just ensure the kill over on him. And Avorst behind Tani. Hellfire Blast. Fnatic trying to get closer for this battery assault. Thunderstrike available in 1 second time. Tani attempted a soul rip, not in time though. As Dendi, Firefly is up, and he sees the Shadow Shaman. A lot easier kill. Mass Serpent Wards are still there. Havos holding onto the Hellfire Blast. He'll get one shock off here, the Wraith King. The Shadow Shaman, sorry. And then the Wraith King will slice him with the Batrider, will actually get the kill with the Firefly. But three heroes going down for Fnatic. They got caught trying to push the tier 1 tower a little bit too hard. And now Na'Vi will take a tier 1 tower of their own. Their first one in this game, 12 minutes in. And some much needed cash will come their way. Skyrocketing the Batrider up. Dendi's able to have a Blink Dagger, as well as his Tranquil Boots and another 900 gold up his sleeve. Fnatic has his full Blade Mail done as well. There's only really one, potentially two BKB heroes coming up from Fnatic. So the Blade Mail will still be rather effective early on. And the Hand of Midas for Revorced. It's greedy, but it's a recovery. Now, Slark pounces on Vanskor. He's got Leap in a moment, but he has to wait out the leash time. Jumps over the trees and then TP's away. Shadow Shaman, Hex. Yep, he even stopped moving right then to question himself. Maybe he thought the shock was enough damage anyway, but safety first, boys. Use that Hex.
Radiant's top tower is under
the range
attack.
Is still pretty damn good. And he would have made it in time before the TP was completed. So, a free escape coming the way there of Vanskor. Trixie back into the middle lane now, farming out. What else has he got? Sentry wards are here. His two deaths really haven't helped him out. Now, Moonlight Shadow. Well, Denny, you did that right underneath the Observer Ward. That's a Radiant one there. So I'm guessing what I said before, like, hey, they did this right underneath each other, those Observer Wards, would be able to scout it out. Havost. Shaman. He's in the Jimmy spot. A little bit further down, he's going to find him out. While Dendi, well, tries to run out. The rocket flies and hits on Boogie. Destiny will continue just to farm up the stacks. FNG is going to make its way over. Revorced. Massive open wards are down. Shackles as well. It's going to be a reincarnation going to trigger on him. At the same time, that's a good ollie from FNG. Boogie. Oh, he got pushed back out by the cogs of Fnatic. He dropped a smack bang in the middle of it. I think he thought he would drag the Doombringer in. Speaking of Doom, we got triggered again over on Denny. Avorce is getting slowed up way too much. He might have to turn for help by a blast to help out his teammate, but he knows the Plague Ward as she fires into him. Venskor as well as FNG, low on life. Venskor gets a small bit of distance off by hitting the arrow on the pass. The Flame Break, Trixie pounds it up. The leap away by Venskor. There's a way to safety. The Clockwork will still go down. The Doombringer will kill him. But Denny survived the entire Doom itself.
Dire's bottom tower.
But the rest of Na'Vi is in no position to fight. They back up, and they lose the T1 tower because of it.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
As Denny now mops up the mid lane. There's only tier 2 towers remaining for Na'Vi. Fnatic, they've still lost two of their T1 towers. They hold their top for the moment. But the team fight is still pretty damn solid. The only thing which makes it really weird for me is the fact that I'm not looking at any form of mech over on Fnatic. We're 15 minutes in there, and no one's building into it. Your Shaman went Blink Dagger, so he wanted initiation first. The Doombringer went Blink Dagger, he wanted initiation first. But no one's got something which allows Fnatic to 100% win teamfights. I'd say 100%. Have really good odds to win teamfights. They got Vision of Trixie. Firefly. Blink Lancer, they're going to try and do this without actually having to use anything more. The arrow actually connected on the Shadow Shaman, which means Hookshot will come in. Trixie goes in the Dark Pack, but the Blade Mail is up and Fnatic. Well, he's trapped inside the Mass Serpent Wall. He's going to battle himself out. Is there a force up? There's a Moonlight Shadow. He did cut his way out of here. Boogie trying to stick with him. But can't do enough. So the Shaman goes down. The Mass Serpent Wards get blown. And where are Na'Vi going next? Voss is already pushing at the bottom lane. He's also building into his own Blade Mail. Either that or he's... Well, where's the mech? Yeah, no one's actually building the mech for this team, so potentially they could go into being a mech. It could also be another Blade Mount. Trixie tries to Dark Pack. The wall is up, however, he's trapped here. Hellfire Blast will trigger two. The arrow's coming off cooldown for Vanskor, but Trixie's already dead. The arrow never able to connect. So two cores for Fnatic dying in basically the space of 1 minute here. Vanskor's now in trouble. Caught out in the bottom river. The Glimpse back. Oh, whoa! That's a big save, your Glimpse. That was the Shadow Shaman right there. It was holding him in position, allowed him to leap away, and then the wall comes up. So FNG saving a teammate while the Hookshot comes in. He's going on past. The Tombstone will be dropped down for Fnatic. He knows with the Blade Mail he can get himself out. Tani. Oh, the Doom will go on Fnatic. Cancel the TP out, but they just keep battling up against it. They will lose the Clockwork for this. Avorced, there's no ultimate available for him. They have a Lion Spy coming in too, but a Vorst. Shackles are up. And he will go down. No reincarnation to save him. So a straight 2-for-2 trade-off. While Denny continues to farm up, his Vorst staff is done. Boogie's also getting a lot of space himself to keep his farm going. And Shadow Shaman, 1 second till these Mass Serpent Wards are off cooldown. And you know where they want to go. That's going to be a shock and a Dark Pack on the Creep Wave. And he's going to save his mana. He's got Arcane Boost Charges, so it's fine. He's just regenerating up Trixie and Boogie if they gathered for a moment. But he's checking for the 18 minute room. He'll get Bottle Charges, it's fine. Trigger the Arcane Boots. Throw down the Mass Serpent Wards. You get yourself a Catapult with you as well. The Rocket's off target. That does scout out what's happening in the lane. Which is probably the main purpose of the Rocket, not just to push the Creep Wave back out. But with the Mass Serpent Wards off cooldown, Fnatic should be looking to bring down some buildings. They've already got a Doombringer that's pretty damn big. They'll buy some more space for him. Fnatic, he knows Roshan's there. Hey, you old Andy. You're a long way over. And then the Plague Ward will hit him. Might be flagging the fact there's some vision around here, but actually, there's none. He just came in range of the Plague Ward. Mid Ward's already gone down. Arrows are coming in too. Something could hit the Creep Wave. Matu had already backed himself up. He's also going to rush into the Aghanim Scepter, which is another reason why these Mass Serpent Wards have to keep getting planted on lane after lane. So they can push down the towers. So the ping comes from the Undying. They have a four-man smoke behind the Shadow Shaman bait, who's going to walk himself up the middle lane, reveal himself, and while Fnatic may think he's actually got the luckiest day in the world, he sees him, and he's considering the hook shot, but it's a complete trap. And with that kind of range jump in, you've got to know there's a problem. The Moonlight Shadow is going to be used by Na'Vi. That will allow them to come in close, and in fact, break off the smoke. Batrider jumps him, the arrow, it connects over on Boogie, and what a disruption wall! Hard from FNG, the Static Storm catches almost all of Fnatic, the Cogs push it back out again. It's a complete disaster fight for Fnatic. Even the Mirana's going to get denied up. Boogie will at least get one kill out from this one, but Avos, he's still got his reincarnation. He can't throw another Hellfire Blast until now. But it's a TD rune Boogie. He might kill off Pass. One crit, needs one crit, doesn't get one. Now level death, Avos will go down, stick charges. He can't fight long enough. Fnatic will fight a little harder and get back a little bit of what they lost at the start of that fight. But that was a huge disruption coming out from FNG. I say disruption, it was just the wall. That static storm was there, the kinetic field. And Fnatic were locked in there. Again though, it's a weird thing from Fnatic. He keeps using his cogs attack in the middle of the static storm and pushing heroes outside of the wall. I don't understand that. Good time to blink, Boogie. Very good time to blink. That was just a blind hook. It wasn't blind for the Radiant side. They had an Observer Ward seeing the clockwork come in. That's where the blink happened. But Fnatic was just having a guess. Unless his rocket, maybe it was his rocket vision he used. Another reason also to blink yourself away. So Wraith King now has his Blade Mail up and running. There's still no initiation coming out from Avorst. He's not really a fighter with this lineup either. Like, if you want to be a fighter, we'd be looking at an armlet build. But that's not there. So they're trying to give Vanskor a couple more levels. But still, becomes a bit of a tense standoff situation when Pass makes a huge wall of wards like he has. While on bottom lane, Trixie, he is going to build into that BKB of his. He's getting sick of this disruptor. And rightly so. But he's one of only two heroes that will have the BKB. The Venomancer won't want to build one. In fact, the Venomancer is now starting up the mech. Took some time, but it's going to arrive. Well, the Batrider is already getting a hell of a lot of farm. Denny's actually sitting up there at 8.5k net worth. It's not on par with the Doombringer, who's got 9.9, but that's a Midas Devouring Radiant's Doombringer, so we always have to accept the fact that he's going to be a lot further ahead in net worth. Especially when you got a hero like a Rasta, Shadow Shaman dropping mass serpent wards on top of towers. You have to accept the loss of towers. Top tower's trying to be a trade-off here for Na'Vi. They've got a catapult behind him. The fortification's also going to be there, but Shaman will take the tower. Fnatic, I think, is trying to stop any kind of TPs out, at least see what was done, as Doom does that. Denny, level dead, and the Doom on him. The leap away, Vanskor, arrow, well off target. And Denny will trigger out. The Doom wasn't letting him go, and Vanskor will trigger out his ultimate. A quick run away. The Moonlight Shadow for protection. Now we've lost, but they could have considered using it on the middle lane, but Pass being very, very defensive. They got a 5 second stun over on Roshan. They're going to put this Vampiric Aura to work. Na'Vi are so behind right now. While the Grumps don't really show it, they're behind in all forms of momentum. And they'll need the Aegis of the Immortal to help them secure a teamfight. The teamfight middle lane was great, but that was only because FNG did a wonderful, wonderful combination. If it wasn't for FNG, that fight would have been completely Fnatic's. But now Havos, they need to finish this. Pass is going to throw a Plague Ward in there. He's a little bit late. He got caught on the tree line pathing. And the Aegis Immortal goes to the Wraith King. Throws out the ulti. The hookshot's coming in. And that's a beautiful hit. And again, the combo from FNG. Fnatic's in the middle of it, but he locked in two heroes. One of them was stunned up by a 5 second arrow from Vanskor. So it was a 3-for-1 trade off at the moment. And it was only the Clockwork to die who. They'll be more than happy with that. Even just going to farm up a tombstone. Why not? 150 extra gold coming their way. The Venomancer, Slark, and Shaman all went down. So, two cores and a support in the sidelines. But Na'Vi can't really make the most out of that win of the fight. Like, okay, they still took Roshan. They still got the Aegis Immortal. It's going to skyrocket them ahead as far as experience, as well as gold. but they don't get any map control from it. They've still lost their bottom lane. It's only just pushed over the river. The top lane's on their side of the river. And the middle lane is being currently tempered in the mid lane. Like, just on the river point. They got gems or something, because, I mean, like, Dendi is being watched as he does this. He's just farming up the jungle camps. Four staff down, he'll notice there's mud golems, and then just get really depressed. Or he could do this. Get the firefly damage into the bottom lane. That's another way of farming it up. Now, the rest of Fnatic are coming up mid. Looks like not the full mech up, but there's a buckler, and Boogie also has the plate mail on him. So a good 19 armor points into him at the moment. And now, hookshot in again from Fnatic. He's just trying to keep him out. The Disruptor ulti will go again. Shadow Shaman can't get Mass Serpent Wars on the field. And that's a big problem, especially when Lasso goes on Trixie. The Slark, he can't move and try and keep fighting on this one. They use the Moonlight Shadow, but the Dust 3 triggered off Fnatic. That's where they get the kill there. FNG now, the Moonlight Shadow will wear off. Try and TP out Trixie. There's nowhere to hold him here. While Lavorst battling up, his reincarnation's already triggered. That's why the extra slow was there, and they're able to get that kill over on the Doombringer. Once they're going to bring down the Tombstone so they can clean up the middle lane. And Trixie just runs Radiant's himself off the bottom. So again, another 3-for-1 trade-off. The kills are at the other end of the Fnatic lineup now. The top two in the mid, instead of the bottom two in the mid last time. But the Shaman, he's praying to get this ultimate off. All he wanted was the Mass Serpent War. It's like smack bang here in front of the tower. But he couldn't get it. FNG on the money, the Static Storm again. Restraining the Shadow Shaman from getting anything done. And he's still trying to build into the Aghanim Scepter. So there's going to be no BKB to try and protect him. And at this rate, you may even see a Disruptor. He's going to build 4 staff. There's no point going in Aghanim Scepter. But if he did ever get to that point, you got some really sad heroes over on the Fnatic lineup. Danny completes up his BKB at the same time. We'll see Trixie complete his own. So the immunities have now arrived for at least the two initiators from either side. Not to mention the nice regeneration route for Dendi. And he instantly moves down. Yeah, there's the Mud Golems to make him sad. Can't farm that with his Firefly. Lavorst is taking stacks. Talk about being a damage dealer. Walking around with the Maelstrom and the Blade Mail. He just stands his ground and fights. And now he's also up at level 16, which means that's a level 3 ultimate. Only 1 minute on the cooldown. Of course, he's still suffering the cooldown from his level 2 ultimate, which was triggered before in the mid-fight. But they definitely do not want to be fighting while his ulti's on cooldown. They're going to wait 1 minute out. And they'll have time. The Aegis the Immortal still got some decent time left on it. Is he going to finish up? He's going to finish up the Fulmi Olinja. Rely on the fact that he has this Aegis the Immortal up his sleeve. What's the courier got as well? She had bought something and then dropped something. Either that or it stole something from the bottom slot. And that's almost enough money. Wraith King sitting here. In fact, yeah, he just wants to pick up the recipe and get this courier back down. He can have the full Mjolnir. Dendi, he sees Trixie. He's going to blink, lasso, drag him back up again. They need more support. Where's this wall? There it is from FNG. Trixie will go down. Even a hook shot from Fnatic. It's only 1 minute for the cooldown, so hey, why not when in Rome? Divorced even now. Cleans up some Plague Wars. They have the Slark down. There's no initiation coming up from Fnatic. And what for me kind of felt like Radiant's superior team fight is not attack. There at all, because the pickups keep coming from Na'Vi. The Batrider's on his job. The Clockwork as well. Radiant's like, even for these interesting cogs coming up from Fnatic, he's pushing heroes out of the Static Storm. He's getting the perfect initiations in. You see Boogie make his move. Blinks forward. Divorce just backs up. He's got his reincarnation back off cooldown. He'll move to top lane, just farm it up. There's more money where that came from. While FNG, TP, quick. The leash should be there, but he's away. Unfortunately, the leash doesn't stop the TP scrolls. And the Slark will deny the tower. Firefly again from Dendi. He's being a nuisance up against Boogie. Taking the farm. He's got potential to BKB TP out. Not to mention Fnatic still hovering around inside the jungle. So if anyone comes from, you got two different stuns that will go through BKB control. So Vorst now gonna push out the top lane. 30 seconds, in fact, until that Aegis is gonna be reclaimed. I'm fairly certain you'd be looking for, well, actually, what would you be looking for as a Wraith King here? I would have said initiation, but it kind of seems like Batrider and Clockwork have that one down pat. Keeping up with them will be important, but maybe they're still looking at him going, we need to get more out of you in the team fights. So either result cure us. The armlet's still not a bad choice. He could try and... there's two BKBs. I was about to say he could try and build into a Heaven's Halberd. But with a BKB over on the Slark, that kind of like is the only hero you want to stop attacking. He could try and go for a Basher and hope he gets to his full Abyssal at one point. But that's a very optimistic kind of Wraith King right there. He might just get the Blink Dagger so he can keep up with the initiation. But he's got 1500 gold in his bank account, so if he spends his money and just picks up a Plate Mail, that'll give us our answer. He's already sitting at 12 armor because of his Blade Mail. I want to watch that Wraith King very closely. We should probably also be keeping an eye on this Doombringer. Because Boogie now has enough money that he can... he's close to finishing up his full Assault Cuirass. It'll cost him his buyback if he does it, though. Rock it on. Well, bottom lane, Fnatic. They're looking for just one target. That's where the arrow is just flittering its way up towards the high ground. Just one person out of position. There's all Na'Vi want before they can do some chip damage into the tier 3 towers. I don't think they can take the tier 3 towers straight away, but they can get some chip in. The rest of Na'Vi are just farming up all of the map. Now Fnatic, they're stuck inside their base. They're behind so far in experience because they can't use any of the map. And 5,000 now gold behind after having a 3k lead. This is not where they wanted to be. And you got Trixie, who's farming up at least the enemy jungle. That's the only area which he probably feels safe in because Na'Vi have taken over his entire jungle. Now in middle lane, FNG, Boogie's gonna be jumping on him. The glimpse away though, and then the wall is up too. The Moonlight Shadow will be triggered, but Dendi, he's looking for a pickoff. There's been no Doom being used. He can see Boogie, but he knows he can't get an instant jump. Not with the Blink Dagger on that Shadow Shaman, because he'll get shackled if he's not careful. So, Fishing Arrow flies.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And the Plague Wards are also watching him. Another problem for Dendi. With these Plague Wards sporadically placed around the initiation jump points, if he gets hit by that, his Plague Ward gets put, Blink Dagger gets put on cooldown. So the item which your force decided to go for, 4-star. A little bit more maneuverability, but more importantly, it's a mana pool, as well as some basic regeneration in for him. FNG, dead. They'll commit Doom for this one. Leash and Dark Pack, so two heroes showing themselves for that kill. But the rest of Fnatic will push this tower. They'll take tier 2 tower and they'll try and go high ground. Vanskor's gonna try and force him into a decision. So the tier 2 tower is lost here. Why?
Dire's top tower.
The mass serpent wards were used to bring down the tower, but that stopped any kind of push. So the decision is taken out of their hands. When Vanskor, when the mass serpent wards went down, you had instantly know that they were going to come back and defend this bottom tower. And Vanskor's got leap away, Avorced. Oh, nice Hellfire Stump. Bought time for magic one charges, and not to mention that blade mount did some serious lifting right then. The Slark's on the sidelines, and what looked to be a horrendous decision from Vanskor turns out to be one of the greatest decisions he's made. Now pushing on the tier 3 towers, and the Slark, where's your buyback? It's there, but he doesn't want to use it. The Hex on, over onto a boss, the arrow, couple of seconds, then he will get the lasso, dragging Boogie back. He's got no Doom available, and now with a plate mail up from a boss, Boogie goes into his own BKB, trying to give him some level of protection. Flamebreak pushing the Shaman uphill, not allowing a force a secondary target to Hellfire Blast into. But Fnatic with Nerves of Steel not buying back on that Slark after it looked like Na'Vi was going to try and breach him on the high ground. Might have also flied because they had two heroes still in the mid, but in saying that, now Na'Vi are going to go in. They find Roshan. Wraith King, stop farming the jungle, Havorst. Four star through and get your ass over there. They need your aura, they need your damage output. And the Medallion of Courage as well, negative armor. They'll rip through him pretty quickly. And Fnatic, how quick can they get there? They'll have to smoke if they want to move at this one, and there it is, there's your smoke. They got the movement speed, but I don't think they got the time. A full Shiva's Guard also arrived for Denny for this fight. The Moonlight Show has been triggered. The Observe Ward is up. And Vanskor, the arrow's already been thrown, but Roshan, there's your kill. Aegis the Immortal goes in, and the jump, the wards, they come up, but actually Tramp Trixie inside of this one. Shadow Shaman's already down, the double blade mount's hurting hard, not to mention the lightning trigger off Trixie. He'll jump in and bring down FNG, but FNG trying to glimpse him away, won't be enough in time. Fnatic on the run, his BKB is protecting him, but the Doombringer and Trixie, they're still on the tail, but a Voss held by a blast. There goes Boogie, couldn't get the level down. Then Fnatic, the Blade Mail is there, Trixie, he goes down. Vanskor's arrow will connect. Harney will TP himself out, but Wraith King, as well as the Mirana, is still alive. Mirana just TP'd straight back. Vanskor didn't want a bar of it. He picks up his Diffuser Blade, but Avost, he's got the Aegis Immortal, his reincarnation's off cooldown 30 seconds time, and he wants pressure on this bottom tier 3 tower to come. So the first thing for Fnatic to think about when they respawn is defense. Avost, gotta fight the creep wave before he can fight the towers. Now the creep wave's arrived, he can fight the tower, but also Harney is here to defense. So Avost will back up. But he's being as aggressive as he possibly can. Not a single buyback coming out during that engagement. But the fact that Roshan was able to be killed off by the Na'Vi lineup gives him, again, a huge burst of experience, a huge burst of gold. And they're really getting so far ahead in this engagement. They've got the perfect control, like, initiating abilities. But as you can see, then they also... like, pumped out a lot of damage. The amount of lightning procs that came out from Mjolnir was so high, and when they both also had their blade mails up and running, the Venomancer thought it was a great idea to attack. So the Shadow Shaman was like, well, we've got two heroes that are trying to do area of effect damage. And then Undying comes in, it's like, well, I got Tombstone, I got my ulti, I've got Decay, I've got Soul Rip. I got all these things which I want to be throwing out. Slug is like, ah, I got Dark Pact, ah, no. BKB is the only thing to protect him, and that means only the Slug and the Doombringer survive. Which is another reason why they were the two heroes that were the only ones left alive. Of course, how do you push a creep wave? Make him go sparkle sparkle. Already gained some hits, Vanskor gonna TP out. No stuns available. Shadow Shaman tried to get there in time with a blink dagger, but didn't make it. While up on top lane, FNG's now starting the push, and you know what I was saying in the late game, what would happen? When Disruptor had some time to farm up. Well, that time is almost there. He's 80 gold away. And he's going to find a camp over on the side. This will give him his 80 gold. He's attacking the big Satyr as well. That's where he gets his bonus money. But that's going to be a full Aghanim Scepter in for FNG. And there's the money. Point boost to purchase and the full Assault Cuirass for Avost. Denny's in trouble in the middle lane. The Shackle's going to be on him. Vanskor, he's already thrown the arrow. I think Denny just said, leave me. Leave me. Shiva's Guard. Flame Break. Can't. 48 life points. The pounce up from Trixie in one attack and he'll get the kill. But they had to work very hard to get that kill on the Batrider. And he's normally meant to be the slightly squishy one. Cogs? Well, that's going to push Trixie back out. He's completely out of mana. He dive packed the second he arrived on the top lane. Which took away all of his mana. The top tier 2 tower will be denied, but right now Na'Vi are so ahead in gold and experience that I don't think they really care about that. The tier 2 tower going down is more of a victory for map control. Moonlight Shadow. Funic. Wait. That's... alright, let's him go. Happy to let the clockwork live, I see. And there's your Assault Cuirass now arriving in for Avost. And he drops his Hand of Midas. Have to sell that Hand of Midas soon. Either that or he's going to use it again when the Aegis the Immortal will expire. Radiant's but he comes up. Goes Disco Disco. Wants the creep wave gone first, then the damage comes directly in towards the tower. The Gale will connect on a Voss, but he doesn't care. He's a vampiric auroring Wraith King. They're just beating down towers who have no fortification available. Now Shaman jumps in, and a Voss just four staffs away. There's a fresh rod of Aoi is now going to be over on Harney. He's a big supporter of that item. And a Voss wants to go in again. He sparkles in 8 seconds. The arrow's coming up. Scouts out the tree line as well as a little bit further down, but a Voss. He just wants the tower. He'll have to mop up the creep wave too though, but yeah. Attacks it towards the tower. The clockwork will die in the meantime. Dying in the mid lane, he'll buy back. Dandy, he sees the Batrider coming in. Blink last two, we got him. While Avost, the wall, he's locked. He's shackled up right next to the Mass Serpent Wards. His reincarnation will trigger. He's still got the Aegis Immortal, however. Remember, it's basically three lines considering the 6 second cooldown on that ultimate. The Riptide, the Soul Rip coming into Boogie. The wall is up, and the Shadow Shaman, as well as Boogie, can't walk away from this. The Lightning procs are not helping them out either. Now the Shaman gets the shackles up. Trixie with the double kill, but Dandy finally brings down the Slug. And now we go for our third Havas, and he crits down the Shadow Shaman. Denny's in there too with the Shiva's Guard, slowing down Harney, the Blade Mail up. That's the way Harney's not attacking him directly. The BKB from Fnatic, try and protect him. And Avost, is he going to come down and help his teammate? Not on your life. Denny wants out of here right now. Up the hill. He's hexed for the moment. Fireflies there. Trixie overshot the mark. Forced up 1 second. Denny doesn't have 1 second. Wraith King is away to safety. They don't bring down the racks. The range racks down in Half-Life. But that's the only chip damage Na'Vi managed to do, and that was with, I'm going to say, three of Vorst. The original, then the reincarnation of Vorst, and then the Aegis, the immortal of Vorst. But he still has 2.6k gold on him. So next time, maybe more damage. Just rack up the DPS. Get Daedalus on this boy. As he's looking towards the bottom, at the bottom lane. While the rest of Fnatic are looking towards the mid. Mass Serpent wants a Salon cooldown. They were the Aghanims upgraded wards too. And this Shaman's got all the confidence in the world because he knows, out of all the heroes of Na'Vi, the arrow is the only thing that could catch him out with initiation. Now that's been thrown. And that's it. Potential glimpse. That's a aggro TP coming from a Vorst, but they use the Moonlight Shadow. He came in perfectly in this. Now FNG needs a glimpse, and it's going to be Boogie. The Sentry Wards will drop, but he's just going to drag someone back. Now FNG throws the ult to Yard. He actually glimpsed him out of his own ultimate. Whoops! The BKB will go out from Boogie. He had the Aghanim's upgrade there too. He wanted that to work, and now Vorst, reincarnation. He'll die again, and then come back to the world of the living. Well, the Mirana has already officially died. Trixie pounces in. Vorst, he's in a lot of trouble. Boogie and Trixie both on his tail. Not to mention the Shadow Shaman's going to arrive. The Na'Vi trying to force something when they only had three heroes up, going up against five of Fnatic.
Dire's middle tower is under.
They will push into this mid-tier two tower.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
And Dendi doesn't have any words to do anything here. Is there a buyback for the Wraith King at least? Yes, he has that. So they can come back to the War of the Living. Both him and Batrider have buybacks. The rest of them do not. So there's no disruptor. Meanwhile, Funnick, he's just going to try and live. Hearing the lasso coming out, his pass being dragged back in. The flame break. He's almost going to go down, but the make charge to keep him alive. The hookshot from Funnick missing. But now Horvost bolt back. And we'll kill off the Venomancer. That's going to be a large amount of gold from Horvost now being wasted. And he's pushing at the mid lane, but unfortunately for him, doesn't earn any money off this. That's that buyback penalty which he's got on him right now. How long till Roshan? Potential spawn time in 10 to 15 seconds. And now be going down to the wire on this battle. And now Roshan. Wow, that was quick. If Na'Vi scout this out right now, like just a field from FNG would do the scouting for him. Or Vanscore. Yep, that'll do it too. Arrow in, 4 seconds on the stun.
With my eyes closed.
This is Nagus and Cheese available. If they just want to jump in and take it. And Denny's already. Okay, they're leaping in the pit. They try and do this without revealing themselves, but there's no way to really do it properly. They got 3 euros inside the pit, but they need the Wraith King in there. And Avorce now walks his way in. They see the Shaman come in. No Hellfire Blast, only an illusion. Second illusion also going to run. This time he uses the Hellfire Blast in case it was a bait. But Roshan's at 8k life points now, 7k life points. And Vorst brings his DPS in. Again, they'll also use the Moonlight Shadow just to ensure that they have the element of surprise on their side. But Fnatic have no desire to come in here and fight this. So the Aegis will be taken by Vorst again. The Cheese will be into the hands of the Clockwork. Which means Denny's going to do it tough. But at the same time, he's got a lot of money on him anyway. So he might be fine with this. He'll probably be looking into, and we saw it up against the Doombringer in the last game, but a Lincoln Spear may be a nice choice for the Batrider. There's still a couple of abilities that could trigger it, but the chance of holding him off with that Doom, or wasting a Doom, that's worth it. The other option is he goes for a Yule Scepter. Starts taking heroes out of the fight, so Vorst's damage can focus a specific target. But Na'Vi are getting poked and prodded on all sides. Trixie, it looks like he's been the main man in charge pushing out that top lane. Shadow Shaman wants to get up here. He's looking for refresher wards right now. Not enough money for it all, just has the Oblivion Staff, but this actually sacrifices his buyback. But they know what they want. They just want to inflict damage into the racks. They need this tier 3 tower gone as well, with no fortification up for Na'Vi. And Na'Vi also very much out of positions. Everyone have a TP scroll? 1, 2, 3, 4. Everyone but Vorst currently owns a TP scroll. And they're all coming top lane. The Mass Serpent Wards are down. First TP in by Funnick. Instantly starts mopping up the Mass Serpent Wards. And the jump in, Danny, Flame Break, BKB. The Tombstone's also been triggered. This kind of like cripples the push power. Avost, wait, what? He can cancel this right now. He doesn't need to be part of this. He drops his four staff and is bringing the courier down to pick up his four staff. So he could TP himself back up to the top lane. It looks like they do just want to mop up the push that came out, but everyone from Fnatic is backed up. The push didn't work, and they're just retreating. And Trixie will push out the bottom lane now. And we're playing a game of cat and mouse. No one wants to fight in this scenario. And Fnatic definitely don't want to. They want to count down the timing of this Aegis the Immortal. But at the same time when they do that, they're giving more and more time for the rest of the cores of Na'Vi to farm up. Not to mention Wraith King. He's got 2.5 minutes until his buyback's off cooldown. And now Havorst, he just bought a full BKB with his four staff. But that means he'll have to drop the blade mail for this. He might be okay with that. As we get refresh at Doom. So the double-double ult is trying to be built up by Fnatic. The Shadow Shaman being the second double. Is Na'Vi gonna force this? Yeah, she ended up selling his blade mail. Not even just dropping it. So the BKB is now more important. He's given up on the blade mail. We are 45 minutes into the game anyway. Arrow. Ooh, Shaman. 5 seconds on the stun on that one. Even without the creep wave, it may have just been enough for a horse just to force stuff up and try and fight it. Now they mob up the mass serpent wards. Have we got gems down from anybody? They're pinging out. They want FNG out of this. They do not want his ultimate. At the same time, Dendi into the Firefly. There's the Doom. It's over on FNG. Dendi's in pretty close, but he's shackled up. They need some extra space for him. Vance going with the arrow. Bought that for him. Fnatic's on the run out of here. The Venomant's gone down while Wraith King. There goes his first light. Fubuki locked in with three heroes outside the base. The Fusil Blade charge being used on him too. He's completely out of mana, and he will go down outside the base. Almost killing off Dendi. Actually successful. The Fiery Ground able to do the work. The Shaman not getting dragged back as far as they would have really liked to. Avorst, four star back out. Trixie looking for the pounce. But the Moonlight Shadows brought him out far enough. The Dust will trigger. And now the ulti from FNG! They had to remember it was still up. The Doom committed everything he had to make sure it wouldn't happen. Again, he actually used two Dooms as well in order to get kills in that engagement. And now there's three heroes down. Avorst just like, let's go bottom! The mid lane was already pushed in. I'm pretty sure the fortification should be off. The mid lane's already coming back anyway. And there's the attack. Yeah, no backdoor regeneration. The fortification will come up. But there's no backdoor regeneration. A clockwork. Cog's just trying to keep the rest of them out. The arrow connects on Trixie. But the melee ranks is almost gone. A boss stays on objective based gaming. Not to mention, this battle's gone on so long, his reincarnation is back off cooldown again. And now Trixie. Glimpse will take him back again. Try to dive back. Not Fnatic. Cog's again. Gonna BKB and Cog. The BKB from Buki then will also trigger. That's 4 seconds, it's 4 seconds. Refresh Orb does actually help bring it off cooldown. Well, Trixie burns some unnecessary mana, running too close to the remaining cogs. As Clockwork, point blank range hook into Vanskor. Gets himself away. Vanskor can also buy up his second level Diffusal Blade now if he wants to. He's got 3k gold. Avorst has 3.6k gold. And Trixie, you're out a long way here, man. That Dire Observer was spotting him out. And he'll blink himself away, realizing after he lost his movement speed that he was being watched. But with 12 points of Stolen Essence, he wants to fight. Vision slightly off. But he's already used Glimpse anyway. So we got Disruptor now. What looks to be going for a double ultimate of Disruptor. How many refreshes can you build in one game? Well, Na'Vi has 10,000 gold that's helping him fund that one. They lost a lot of experience. And just the course of like 3 to 4 minutes, they're able to lose 12 to 13,000 worth of net worth. And now Avorst. He did actually end up going for the Basher. He needs that control over on the Slark. So both the luxury items of the Disruptor as well as the Wraith King are being farmed up. Got some fresh Observer wards out from FNG, trying to keep himself secret. Because in the last engagement, you could see what happened. Like, they spotted out the fact that the Disruptor was sitting here, and Doombringer purposefully walked around the side in order to get that jump in. Well, okay, draw an arrow correctly, Toby. Because he's got the Blink Dagger, it actually is more of a straight arrow. But the Rockets are watching Fnatic's movements very closely. Well, Avorsa sits on the front lines. He's the man with reincarnation. Another arrow on the way up. Goes straight through the catapult. More scouting of the high ground. As another rocket comes in, scouts at Harney and Undying. They kind of want the Doombringer's position. That's why the Doombringer is very, very deep inside of his own base. And they're not getting that kind of intel. How's Dendi actually looking? Got a lot of money on him. But he's just moving back and farming up. The Aegis Immortal is gone, so Na'Vi won't want to fight unless they really, really have to. They're getting all their buybacks back off cooldown. Now that Avorsa is now 53 gold away from having it. And you got Roshan, yeah, there's the scouting, but it's 1 minute until potential spawn time, so more hopeful scouting coming out there from Vanskor than anything else. The amount of Roshan kills we've seen today. A lot. The amount of long games I've had today. Also, quite high. From both ESL as well as from D2CL tonight. Avorsa, 2.6k gold on him. Yeah, but supply's actually not far off for him. I really want to see the spawn time of Roshan. How long have they got to wait? It was pretty damn quick for last time for Na'Vi.
Double damage.
Well, I say they might have wanted to save that one, but hey. Roshan's still up shortly. Na'Vi just keeps farming up. Fnatic is trapped in their base. They got no way out unless they smoke move. And they don't know if they're going to be spotted or not. They don't know how the aggressive wards are planted. And you see, it plateaus a little bit because they're still farming up the creep waves when they reach the base, but they're not getting any of the money coming out from the jungle. So the Doombringer is trying to, he's semi-offsetting this by using his Devourer as well as Midas. But that's all. And the bottom wave is also worth less money. Because it's the supersize me creeps. The Vorst almost has that Abyssal Blade. It's a couple of hundred gold off. Roshan spawn timer, so it's almost 2 minutes for him. I don't think Na'Vi really want to hold back that long. And Vanskor trying to stack the life steal. Vladimir's aura. As well as having the vampiric aura.
Boom! There it goes.
A fresh gem now being purchased up by Undying. The vision's not coming from wars though inside Radiant's the base, it's coming from somewhere else. Attack. It's coming from the rocket spam. As well as the arrows from Orana. City now has himself a refresher orb, so might be sell is when he sell the tranquil boots or what does he sell here? Like, he four stars up, you might have to get rid of, the TP scroll. Which means if Denny's gonna fight, he fights the whole way. He doesn't hold back. 51 minute S and Y. And Trixie. At this point of the game, like, you would have been hoping to get an Abyssal Blade or something like that so you can control the Wraith King, but they just don't have it, so he gets an S and Y instead. Speed and strength during the fight, but no control. And there's that Abyssal Blade. Avorsa sacrifices all of his buyback in order to have this. But he may just drop the four staff so he can pick up the Aegis the Immortal, and that way he takes no risk. FNG, it might actually be a good idea to put that Aegis the Immortal over on him. If Doom's going to focus him at the start of the fight, you want to have his ultimate. In fact, he needs the ultimate. The team needs the ultimate. Roshan's going to spawn in a moment. Trixie, he's got potential to scout out for it, but Vanskor's trying to make sure they've got to watch their side lane. What's coming out in that courier now? It's just a ring of health for FNG. The fact that he just picked that up makes me now question the fact he'll take the Aegis the Immortal. Trixie will come in. Scouts at Dark Pack, expects him to be there. The rocket will scout out. I don't know if they actually saw Trixie. Avorsa, whoa, hey! Oh, four staff, get out of there, Avorsa! He walks into the pit. Trixie's also just running in. The Hellfire Blast, we Dark Packed, but Avorsa looks for the damage. They jump in. The Lazu's there. Trixie will go down. Dendi, he's got the Refresher if he wants to use it, but now he's getting doomed up. The Disruptor will die. No buyback available. He's short the money. Avorsa reincarnation will now trigger. Vanskor still enabled. The Sentry Ward's giving them all the vision. That's why this Moonlight Shadow's not helping them out. Fnatic, no hookshot available. Has the BKB, but Avorsa now tries to go man mode. The arrow's coming in too. Flies astray as she's soaked up by one of the units. And Trixie pounces his way up. Still refresher orb available here for Denny. He might actually have to use it. The Shiva's Guard will go. Boogie almost in range from the Hellfire Blast, again going into the Doombringer, and they flame break him up on top of the hill. The Shackles though from the Shadow Shaman, they need him gone, freeing up Avorsa. There it goes, Doombringer fires back, passing the sidelines to and Trixie. Now the damage dealing is finally coming online. Harney four stars him away, Vanskor, no way to jump up. Fnatic does however, he four stars up, but remember why they came here. They can look for kills, sure. The Rod of Aoi slowing them down, there's not enough mana to really chase this down any further. But they came here for Roshan. And Avoris is taking care of that right now. They need to get back there to get the Aegis and Cheese onto the right heroes. And Avoris is being out going, yo guys, I don't have enough slots in my inventory to make this work. And Avoris, there it is. Aegis and Cheese on the deck, and he leaves all of them behind. So Dendi, what do we got? Defunic, actually, he took the Aegis the Immortal. What the hell did he do with the cheese? What the hell did he do with the cheese? Did he just sell the cheese? I gotta watch on my side screen for this one. Avoris pushing down mid lane in the meantime. What the hell did he do? The cheese is not a hero. It's not over on the courier. Was my camera on it? Was my camera on it? No, my camera was not. Ah, oh, balls. My combat log also bugs out every single time. So I can't even look at that. Yep, no, it's... I'm sorry. This little sucker, yeah. It's always blank. Jump in. They got Boogie. Dragging him back. Avoris. There's your crit damage time. The Soul Rip. Trying to keep Boogie alive. He's in the fire and the flames. He gets a pistol bite up too. They need to kill him off. The Shiva's guard's keeping away by the ultimate from Disruptor. It's controlling up the Shadow Shaman. He got his wards down. The Aegis Demon will be triggered on the clockwork here. And now they beat into the melee Rex. The Hex over on Fnatic, but Na'Vi knows what they came here for. They want the map control. They got the bottom ranks. They're taking out the mid ranks. Slots up 2 seconds from now. Rod of Alley on Dendi. The four star, not available, but they turn for the fight. Pass, hook shot in. Wraith King's already got him. He's got his reincarnation off cooldown, so he's good to fight for that one. Ashi will be triggered by that Dark Pact. But Avoris back toward the living. Sees the Shadow Shaman. Hexes him up straight away. Trixie, the BKB going from him again. Now it's already worn off. And the wall is up. FNG is out with Juken around the flame ray, buying some space. We're on a double sided fight at the moment. The hook shot down actually goes through the Shadow Shaman, slowing him down, allowing Benscore to get this kill. While Dendi back into the engagement. Looks like with the Lazzy, he was able to hold Harney out of the engagement too. Boogie dragged back in with a glimpse. More heroes coming back. Avoris back toward the living with the BTs. Searching for Trixie outside the base. But inside the base, the Undying will go down. Trix is the only man alive for his team at the moment. And a Yasha freshly purchased up by Vanskor. The pounce in. Trixie. Oh, he's already used Dark Pack. That could be it. That could be GG. They've lost too many heroes. And they can just take tier 4 towers. And Fnatic will call it. So Na'Vi and Fnatic seem to be cursed by the same plague. Every game in D2CL a draw. And honestly though, that was the first game of Fnatic. It was the second series of Na'Vi. It's not putting either team in the greatest positions for the D2CL, but it keeps them alive. Fighting hard, a loss really does cripple you in this competition. And that is a two-game series. That is over for FNG. But the stream is not. We'll have ourselves a short break. I believe we have ourselves another... Yeah, we have 20 minutes roughly. We might start earlier for Na'Vi US. We'll be going up against Sneaky Nick's Assassin. So it's a triple Na'Vi night here on the joinDOTA live streams. Hope you are enjoying the show. And we'll see you guys back here in a couple of moments' time for Na'Vi US versus Sneaky Nick's Assassins.